There is a new minority government supported by the NDP, by the Bloc, and I'm wondering how that fares for your business. How does that bode for your business for the future?
I would tell you that I think the last 40 days of election, I think everybody started reasoning a little more logically. I think everybody realized that there were certain advantages given to certain people that should not have been given. My business, I think, will continue thriving. I think that the movie Avengers sent a message out that there's nobody in the world, no platform in the world that could write a check for $1.1 billion to any movie producer to compensate that they should have the movie versus movie theaters should. Because that's the money that Walt Disney made after it paid for the movie and paid for the marketing, whatever. So I don't see the movie theater business going anywhere. In fact,
But is it easier for you to work with one type of government versus another?
No, actually, you know, the truth of the matter is, it's a little awkward because somebody told me this during the campaign. Says you should be happy that there's a fiscally irresponsible government, because what happens is that'll drive us into a recession, and recessions are good for movie theaters. So, you know, in all intents and purposes, it's a different way of looking at things sometimes. For me, what's important is that creators are being supported. Quebec creators, in a big way, because most of my theaters are concentrated in Montreal, Greater Montreal area, so that's where I'm getting the benefit. But I was at a board meeting today with Telefilm. I'm involved. I try and explain to them what needs to get done. And I think that this government in a minority position will have less of a arrogant stance. So minority governments are usually good for avoiding extreme positions. And I think that the last 4 years were extreme in the sense that we were told, be quiet, this is what it is, and you have no say.
You started to touch on this at the beginning of this conversation. There's this notion that movies and the movie business are recession-proof. And as you push into expansion with greater bricks and mortar across Canada, you're doing it at a time of streaming wars. Apple TV, Disney Plus, are you, or do you feel threatened at all?
No, because see, what's really happening is the business that the studios lost, which is the DVD business, the video business, they're now gaining back. In fact, that's why, let's just remember this. We had a DVD market. So you would make movies straight to DVD. You now make movies straight to streaming, straight to Netflix. Those movies were always labeled.
Doesn't that eliminate you then?
No, because if you remember well, when the DVDs and the videos were around, it was understood that those were subpar movies. Those were the movies that, every movie starts with a great screenplay and the vision. But then when you make it, sometimes, maybe it didn't turn out as well. And so your option is you always go for the movie theater release. But then when it doesn't quite work out, then you just pass it on to DVD, pass it on to streaming. So all that's happening with Sony, Apple, Warner's is going to come into the game. Everybody's just going to regain what they lost in the DVD market. And the third-party players like Netflix, they'll have to find something to exist, or they'll just be bought out by one of the studios.
You think?
Oh, I'm telling you. You know what? It would be really, it would be irony, and it would be like real karma if Paramount Pictures bought Netflix, because it's Netflix that put Blockbuster into bankruptcy, and that was a division of Viacom, which is Paramount, and so forth. So it would sort of be like full circle. When I said this to the president of Paramount, he started laughing. He says, I'd really like to see that happen. and so it's part of the game.
You seem to be battling, at least here in Canada, Cineplex. In their second quarter, Cineplex posted theater attendance declines and also net revenue declines. Is that a concern for you?
It's a concern for their shareholders. It's not a concern for me because we didn't go through the same reaction. Our revenues were up 2% and our attendance was flat. So that means we actually got a few more dollars out of people without necessarily getting more butts in the seats, as we say. You have to remember that when you play over all of the provinces, you sort of average out your game. But what happens sometimes is that when a regional movie, like in Quebec, when we had, Montage, or when we had some of the local product, that will make a difference. And so our numbers were up. In fact, movie theater independents in Quebec are up 8% to date. Cineplex is still down in the province. I'm still down in the province. Why? Because some of these Quebec-grown movies work better in outlying areas of the big city, right? So it's not a problem. You have to remember, going to the movies is a content-driven business. It's not about the platform. You know, everybody says to me, our movie theater is going to disappear. Is streaming going to win? It's not about streaming or movie theaters. It's about the content. If the content is worth paying for, people will go. If the content's subpar, people say, well, it's free at home on TV. And you have to remember, everybody, you know, we talk about streaming as if it's this new novel thing. Mm-hmm. It's TV, it's TV, right? So it's just, call it TV. Why do we have to call it streaming? It's just TV against movie theaters, which has been an ongoing battle for 100 years.